Able to see the compound curve on your screen. Yesterday we had studied. Yes, so I hope you are able to see the compound curve which we had studied in the previous class. So these elements are very important for us to understand. So let us recall whatever we had studied yesterday. So the first thing was we have two curves. We have two curves. One is smaller one. You can see in red. We have one small curve and we have one larger curve in green color. Okay, so they have their respective centers O1 and O2 over here. The angle subtended by the smaller curve is delta 1. The angle subtended by the larger curve is delta 2. And the radius of the shorter curve is RS, and for the shorter and for the longer curve it is RL. Okay, this point we know it is T1, this point is T2. And the common point is known as point of common curvature, which is represented by this letter D. Now, at this point, we have drawn a tangent. You can see it is meeting this particular tangent line. Okay, this particular tangent line, it is meeting at D1. Here, similarly, it is meeting at D2. So this tangent line T1 to D is equal to D1D. And similarly, this tangent length T2 to D2 TL, which we call as, is equal to D2 to D. This distance is equal to this distance. That is tangent of the longer line, small TL. Then coming to this larger tangent length from T1 to B. T1 to B is the tangent length of the shorter curve, that is TS, okay, capital TS. And from T2 to B, it is capital TL. So these are a few things that we require for solving the cases. So moving on to next thing. So we have studied yesterday a few relationships. Okay, so TS, what is TS? TS is nothing but this tangent length, shorter tangent length over here. So TS is equals to, we know it is R tan delta, right? We know the general formula for tangent length. It is R tan delta. So TS, we are dealing with shorter curve. So the radius of the shorter curve will be used, RS, and delta will be used of the shorter curve, that is delta 1. Okay. Similarly, for the larger tangent TL, this particular tangent length TL over here, TL, this is equal to what? R tan delta by 2. But here R will be radius of the larger curve, delta will be angle subtended by the larger curve, delta 2. Okay, so this is one property which you have to remember, and this delta, the total angle subtended is equal to delta 1 plus delta 2. Very important. So once we are done with this, we were studying the second case, right? We have done with the first case. Now we were studying the second case. So in the second case, I think we have covered, these were the given, right? All these four in red which you see are the given values. Delta, RS, RL, and TS, longer tangent length, tangent length of the shorter curve is given. Then this particular delta, delta 1, delta 2, and TL we have to calculate. Delta 1, delta 2, and tangent length of the longer curve we have to calculate. So we had calculated delta 1, delta 2, we were left out with TL. Correct? So we had to calculate TL. So what is TL equal to? Let me show you. See, you can see TL. Here TL is equals to BT2 is equals to PQ. So where is this relation? Let me show you. TL is what? TL is equals to, I hope you are able to see. TL, where TL is T1L, okay, T not T1L, we are dealing with, correct, TL, tangent of the longer curve, TL is equal to what? Is equal to BT2, is equal to BT2, is equals to PQ. BT2 is where? Here you can see B to T2. This particular red color line which you see is that longer tangent line TL, okay, that is also equal to PQ, okay, this line, smaller line, is a perpendicular line. So this BQ is equal to the longer tangent length BT2. Okay, we have considered this PQ. So what is this PQ equal to again? PQ is equal to QD dash plus, sorry, QD dash plus D dash B dash minus B dash. Okay, so this PQ is equal to what? PQ is equal to what? You can see on your screen, it is equal to Q D dash. This PQ is equal to this Q D dash plus D dash up to B dash we are taking. Okay, Q D dash from this D dash to B dash total minus this B dash P minus this length will give you P to Q. Okay, I hope you have understood. From Q dash D dash add D dash B dash total length we have to consider, then minus B dash P. So you will be left out with what? You will be left out with P Q. Okay, now what is Q dash D dash? What is Q dash D dash? You can see Q dash D dash is nothing but O 1 S. It is nothing but O 1 S. Okay, so Q dash D I have written as O 1 S plus B dash D dash. We know it is T 1 B minus B dash. This D dash B dash, right? This D dash B dash D dash up to B dash is nothing but the tangent length of the shorter curve over here, which you have considered T 1 B D dash. It is the tangent for this particular curve, right? So that particular value we have already calculated. So now we have all these things with us, hence we can calculate TL. So we are done with all the cases. We have calculated delta 1, we have calculated delta 2, also we have calculated TL. So we are done with the second case. So we are done with the second case. All these three values which were required, we have calculated. So this was the second case. Similarly, we have one more case. Similarly, we have one more case. That is the third case, which is similar to the second case. This was a second case. You can see this is our second case wherein we have to find out what? Delta 1, delta 2 and TL. Now coming to the third case, you can see on your screen, you can see the third case which you can see. Okay, so this is your third case. Case 3. Okay, what is given in case 3? Are you able to read what is given in case 3? What values are given in case 3? Are you able to read on the screen? Is it visible clearly? Yes, is it visible? Can anyone let me know? Is it clear, visible on your screen? Is it able, are you able to read whatever is there? Are you able to clearly see the diagram? Okay, I hope you are able to see. So we will move on with the calculation. So the first thing is we have to learn how to draw this particular curve. So initially what we will be having with us, we will be having this curve T1D, B2, D2, with this green color curve, shorter curve of radius RS and center O1, and the angle subtended is delta 1. Similarly, over here you can see this is your longer curve D2 T2 of radius RL, center at O2, angle subtended is delta 2. Okay, now this is the tangent T1B for this particular longer curve. T1B is the tangent length. Similarly, we have tangent length of the shorter curve, tangent of the shorter curve, that is T1 to B, and the angle subtended between these two and the angle between these two tangents we have named as delta. You can see we have named it as delta. Next, what we have to do in this particular case, what you have to do is, you can see I have extended this curve T2D, I have continued this curve and I have reached it up to D dash. Okay, I have continued this particular curve, continued, and I have reached up to D dash. So where this D dash, or where up till where you have to extend, is until you get delta over here, okay, delta, which is summation of delta 1 plus delta 2. Until you arrive at delta angle, you have to continue this curve and you have to mark this point D dash. So mark this particular point D dash. Now, after that, what you can do, you can join this particular line D dash to O2, you can join, no problem, you can join this particular line. Then this particular delta, this particular tangent of this shorter curve T1B, you can extend and join it and name that point as Q. Extend this particular tangent to meet it at this radius line and name it as Q. Okay, then what you have to do, you have to draw this line, okay, O1S, you have to draw perpendicular to this radius line, to this particular radius line. Draw this O1S perpendicular. You can see I have drawn with the 90 degree symbol over there. Next, similarly here what you have to do, BP, okay, this particular line BP, short line, you can see that also line is perpendicular to this tangent line D dash B dash. To this particular tangent, this BP line is perpendicular. Although it may not seem like perpendicular, consider that line to be perpendicular. Okay. So this particular diagram, this particular triangle, I have drawn an enlarged view over this side. Enlarged view I have drawn on the other side. Okay. So this is how you can draw this particular figure for your case 3. This is how you have to draw your, in your case 2, what we had done, we had continued this particular shorter curve, right? We had continued the shorter curve and we had drawn like this. But in the third case, what we will do, instead of the first curve, we will extend the second curve. That is a longer curve we have extended. That is the difference. Now, what all is given to us? We have been given with delta. We have been given with RS, RL and TL. Delta, RS, RL and so what we need to find out, required, you can see required is what, delta 1, delta 2 and TS. These are required. So similarly, as we have done in the second case, we have to do, or we have to solve the third case also. So what we had done, if you recall, first thing that you have to do is you have to calculate B dash D dash. First thing what you have to do is calculation of B dash D dash. You can see the first thing that you have to do is calculation of B dash D dash. So T2 B dash is also equal to B dash D dash. B dash D dash is where, here you can see B dash to D dash, this particular line, right? It is what? It is the tangent to this long curve, right? To this long curve T2 B D dash. To this particular long curve, it is a tangent B dash D dash. And this is also equal to what? B dash T2. B dash T2 is also a tangent for the same curve. Similarly, this particular B dash D dash is also a tangent. So we know the tangent formula, it is what? R tan delta by 2. R tan delta by 2 is the general formula. In this particular case, what it will be? R will be RL, right? Because it is the curve of the longer curve, right? So we have to use the radius of the longer curve, RL. So RL tan delta by 2, because this particular angle is what? Delta. It is summation of delta 1 and delta 2. And we know the summation of delta 1 and delta 2 is equals to delta. Right. So this angle subtended totally, it is delta. So it is RL tan delta by 2. So this is the first thing that you have to do, similar as we have done in the second case. Next, the third step, second step, what you have to do, second step. In the second step, you have to calculate BP. Okay, BP, same thing, BP, then go for B dash P, and then go for O2S. Okay, now let us try to draw, I'll try to solve it for you. So I hope, I think it is not visible. Let me change the orientation. Okay. Okay. In this particular thing now, we have to calculate what? We have to calculate first, as I've told you, we have to calculate B dash P. We have to calculate B dash, or we can calculate BP first, BP. From this triangle, now tell me what is BP, using which triangle, which trigonometry function can you calculate BP in terms of this hypotenuse. We know this hypotenuse, in terms of hypotenuse, you have to calculate this BP. So you have to use what? You have to use. So we need this, we know this particular hypotenuse length. So, and we have to calculate this particular thing. So we can use sine. Sine is what? Opposite upon hypotenuse. So we can use sine. So sine delta is equals to opposite BP by B dash B. Correct? B dash. Okay. So again, simplifying this, we know what we want. We want BP. So this particular thing will go on the other side. So it will become B dash B sine delta. Correct? No problem. Now, what is this B dash B? What is this B dash B? B dash B, you can see it is here, this particular side, or this particular side in red, you can see, or this thing in red. So what is B dash B? We will try to find out. It is nothing but T2 B dash, the whole thing T2 B dash minus T2 B. Correct? The whole thing minus this will give you B dash B. So the whole thing is T2 B dash minus B T2. This thing I've expanded. Sine delta is there as it is. Okay. This particular thing I've expanded. Sine delta is there. No, sorry, it is not delta 1. It is sine delta as it is. Now, what is T2 B dash? What is T2 B dash? What is T2 B dash? T2 B dash is nothing but the tangent, right? It is a tangent to this particular long curve. So it is RL tan delta by 2 minus T2. This is what? This is TL sine delta. I have written as it is. What is we have calculated? We have calculated BP. We have calculated BP. Okay, this is for BP. I've told you this T2 B dash is nothing but RL tan delta by 2 and B2 T2. It is what? This thing. This particular B2 T2, it is what? It is nothing but what we write as TL, right? TL, capital TL. We have learned that in elements of compound curve. Right? So that is what I've written over here. So we have calculated BP. Next, what we have to calculate? Next, we have to calculate, as I've told you, remember the steps. First, calculate B dash, B dash, B dash B calculate, then you have to calculate BP, then you have to calculate B dash B. Calculate B dash B. Now, you can see in this particular small triangle over here, where is B dash P? It is here. B dash P is here. So this, in terms of hypotenuse, if you want, you have to use cos delta. Cos delta. So cos delta is equals to base upon hypotenuse. Correct? Base upon hypotenuse length. Now, that is done. Then we want B dash P, right? We want B dash P. So I'll take this on the other side. So it will become B dash B cos delta is equals to B dash P. This thing, right? This thing we already know. This thing we already know. Here you can see we have calculated it is this bracket is what is B dash B. So I'll write directly RL tan delta by 2 minus TL cos delta as it is I've written is equals to B dash. So we have calculated B dash P. Okay. Is it clear, guys? Are you following? Are we going correctly? Are you following? Let me know if you are following correctly. Yes. Yes. No problem. Are you there following?
Yes, sir.
Okay. 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 So we are done with B dash. Next, I have told you, after you calculate, first thing I have to calculate B dash, T dash, first, second, third. Next, what I have to calculate? O2S. O2S. Fourth thing that you have to calculate is O2S. Okay. Now, where is O2S? O2S, let us see in the diagram, where is O2S? Okay. O2S is here. O2, 2S. This particular distance is O2S. Okay. O2S, to calculate this O2S, what we have to calculate, we can see that we have to add D dash O2, this total thing D dash O2, which is nothing but radius of this longer curve. That radius of this longer curve, that is nothing but RL. What is RL? D dash to O2, the whole thing. From this whole thing, if you minus this D dash Q, if you minus D dash Q, and if you minus Q to S, D dash Q and QS, if you minus from the whole thing, you will be left out with O2S. Correct? So what is the whole thing I have told you? It is nothing but RL. What is this D dash Q? D dash Q? D dash Q is nothing but BP. It is nothing but BP, because this line is perpendicular to the tangent and this line is also perpendicular to this tangent. Okay. So the this line I have told you, it is what? It is equal to BP. Then what is QS? What is QS? This particular line from Q to S, it is nothing but, right? If you extend this up to here, you can see it is nothing but RS. Correct? It is nothing but RS. Right? S, if you go to O1, and Q, if you consider at T1, it is nothing but what? It is nothing but RS. So now we have calculated what? O2S. Now let us write down clearly what we have just observed. Now O2S is equals to, I have told you, the whole thing is what? D dash Q, sorry, D dash O2, D dash O2, the whole line minus D dash Q minus QS. So this thing I have told you, it is nothing but radius of the longer curve. This I have told you is nothing but BP, and this is what? QS is nothing but RS, right? So we know RL, we know RS. BP also we have calculated, right? BP we have calculated here, BP. So all the things are known, so we can calculate OS. So O2S is done. Okay, O2S is done. After O2S is done, we have to look for this short triangle over here. The triangle which is at the base, the smaller triangle which is at the base. Okay, this particular triangle, are you able to see O2, O1, O2S? Small triangle, O1. O2S, this particular 90 degree triangle which you can see on your screen. Okay. O1, O2S. Is it visible? O1, O2S. So what I have done? I have to consider this O1, O2S. So from triangle O1, O2S, I have to consider this triangle. This is the fifth step. Okay. Fifth step. This particular triangle O1, O2, yes. Now, remember, when you are dealing with this particular triangle, go for cos delta. Whatever is the delta over here, consider. So here we can see it is delta 1. So I'll consider delta 1. Okay, cos delta 1. Similarly, after you are done with cos delta 1, go for sine delta 1. Okay, sine delta 1. Remember the steps. After you are done with cos, go with sine. So we will write for cos. So can you tell me what is the value of cos delta 1 over here? Cos delta 1, if you are able to read, can you tell me what is cos delta 1 here? Cos delta 1. Which side upon which? Cos. Quickly have to answer. Try to answer. Or what are the sides that we are concerned with here? Cos delta 1 in that particular smaller triangle O1, O2, yes. No answer, no idea. Cos is what? Base upon hypotenuse. Base upon hypotenuse. Okay, what is base? Base is O2S. Base is O2S. And what is hypotenuse? Hypotenuse here is O1, O2, O1, O2. So base, I will write down. What is base? This is the base, right? This is the base of this triangle. So it is O2, S divided by the hypotenuse length. That is O1, O2, O1, O2, O2. Now what is this O1O2? What is this O1O2? You can see O1O2 is here. This total length minus this length. Total length O2 to D minus this length O1 to D. If you do, you will get O1O2. Correct. Now what is this total length? It is nothing but the radius of this longer curve. Right. It is the radius of this long curve. So RS minus this is what? This is length radius of the short curve RS. This is O1 to D is nothing but RS. So O1 O2 is what? O2S I will keep it as it is. O2S I'll keep it as it is divided by what? RL minus RS. RL minus RS. So from here, what we can do is we can calculate delta 1 from this particular equation, right? We can calculate delta 1, which is unknown, right? We have to calculate delta 1, we have to calculate. So you can read in required, you can see delta 1 is unknown. Delta 1, we have calculated now. Delta 1, we have calculated because O2S is already known to us, right? We have an equation for O2S, we can calculate because RL and RS and BP, all these things are known. We can calculate O2S. So O2S is known, RL is known, RS is known. So hence we can calculate delta 1. Okay. Similarly, we know an equation, right? Delta is equals to delta 1 plus delta 2. We know this particular thing, this particular property. So if we know this particular delta, now we have calculated delta 1, we can easily calculate delta 2. Correct. Delta 2 is equals to what? Delta minus delta 1. So we have calculated delta 2, we have calculated delta 1, which was required. You can see we have calculated delta 1, we have calculated delta 2. Now we are left out with TS. Correct, we are left out with TS. So as I've told you, the steps, remember, once you calculate cos, go for the calculation of sine, go for the calculation of sine. So in this same particular triangle, same particular small triangle, now calculate sine delta 1. What is sine delta 1? Sine, we know it is opposite by hypotenuse. Opposite is what? Opposite is O1. O1S divided by hypotenuse length. That is nothing but O1, O2. Okay. Now same thing, O1, O2, what I'll write? I'll keep O1S as it is. O1, O2 I'll write as RL minus RS. Same thing. Now here from this particular equation, we have to calculate O1S. You have to calculate O1S. Okay, so I will keep everything in O1S here and I'll take this on the other side. You can write it on the other side. It will become RL minus RS here and equal to O1S. Okay, so that is required. So we have kept it over here. Next, after this is done, what you have to do? We have to calculate TL. So we are left out with TL, right? We are left out with TL. So for this particular calculation of TL, we require this O1S. O1S. Hence, we are calculating this using sine delta 1. Okay. Now moving on for the calculation of TL. Calculation of TL. What? Where is TL? TL is nothing but length of the tangent length of the longer curve. Tangent of the longer curve. That is BQ. BQ minus T1. BQ minus T1Q. BQ minus T1Q. Okay. TL. BQ. Where is BQ? You can see BQ is here. BQ minus T1Q, BQ minus T1Q here. Okay, sorry, we are not calculating TL, we are calculating TS, sorry. We are calculating TS. This is TS. So what is TS? TS is nothing but tangent length of the shorter curve, which is from T1 to B. T1 to B, this is the tangent of the shorter curve, T1 to B. So what is T1 to B? How can we calculate T1 to B? We will consider the total length B to Q. We'll consider the total length B to Q minus Q T1 minus Q T1 or T1 Q. Okay, this is TS. This is TS. Okay, now what is BQ? BQ here, BQ, you can see BQ, it is nothing but B dash D dash. Okay, it is nothing but, you can see it is nothing but B dash D dash. So I will write here as B dash D dash minus T1Q. What is now T1Q? T1Q is here. T1Q is here, which is nothing but, you can see here, it is nothing but O1S. it is nothing but O1 S. So instead of T1 Q, I'll write O1 S. So O1 S, we already know, we know the value of O1 S, right? We have calculated previously. So B dash D dash is also known, we have calculated, right? Let me show you. B dash D dash is known. This is the first step what we do. B dash D dash is known. Also O1 S is also known. Hence we can calculate TS. TS we have calculated, no problem. So all of the things which were required, we have calculated, right? So all the things that were required, that is delta 1 we have calculated, delta 2 we have calculated, also TS we have calculated in the last step. Okay, so is this particular case clear to you guys? Case 3, is the case 3 clear? Case 3, I hope it is clear. Those who have understood case 3 can raise their hands so that I get an idea whether you are understanding or not. Raise your hand. You have an option to raise your hand. Please click that button and let me know whether you have understood or not. Okay. Yakpa, Namokar, Nakshatra, Nehal, you have not understood. Prajwal, Yava part Artharth, you have not understood. Let me know, I'll explain. Then Shreya Khade, Soumya, I think you guys have joined late, so you have not understood. Let me know which part which part you have not understood. I'll explain once more if you want. If you want me to explain once more, let me know which part. Okay, you can lower your hand. No problem. Thank you for your feedback. Okay, so we are done with case 1. We have done case 2. Okay, we have done case 2. Now we have to calculate case 2. Case 3 is also done. Now we have to look into case 4. Okay, case 4. Case 4 is easy. Case 4 and case 5 are very short, very easy. If you are done with case 1, case 2, case 3, if you understand clearly, case 4 and case 5 are very easy for you to understand. Okay. For case 4, let me show you where is case 4. So for case 4, we will be requiring the same figure, okay? The case for case 4, we will be requiring the same, that is figure number 2. That is the figure which we have drawn for the case number 2. Okay, that particular case, again, that particular figure, same figure we will be requiring for the calculation of your case 4, okay, case 4. So I hope you remember how we have drawn this particular particular figure, okay, case 4 figure. In this case, okay, what is the given value? Given value you can read on a screen. Given values are delta, given values RS, RL and TS. These are given to us. These four values are given to us. The unknown things are delta 1, delta 2 and TL. These are unknown. Okay, and this is your particular figure number 2, which we are referring, which is same from the case 2. Same case 2 figure we are referring. Okay. Wherein we had extended this particular shorter curve we had extended to meet at D dash, and then we had drawn this particular tangent, right? D dash is the tangent to this short curve, and then this particular D dash Q is the radius, that is rs. Okay, it is nothing but rs. Now this shorter triangle at the top, which you can see here, I have drawn an enlarged view over here, enlarged view I have drawn of this particular shorter triangle, which is, I think it is not clearly visible to. So this particular small triangle, I have drawn an enlarged view for you over here. Okay, so this is the figure which we will be referring now for the solution of your case number 4. Case number 4. Okay, so you can see on your screen case number 4 is written. Case number 4. Case number 4 given is delta, given is RL, TS, and given is TL. So these values are given to us. What is given? Delta, RL, TS, and TL. What is required? Delta 1, delta 2, and RL is required. Okay, required. So what we are going to do? We are going to refer figure number 2. Figure number 2, which is over here. Figure number 2, I have shown it is over here. Figure number 2, the same figure which we have drawn for case number 2. Same figure we are referring. Okay. So as we are referring the same case number 2, so some results that we have already calculated, some results which we have calculated in case 2, we will be using over here. Okay, case 2, some results we have calculated, the same thing we will be referring. So from case 2, we have b dash d dash, right? This is the first step. I have told you always calculate b dash d dash first. That value we have already calculated in case 2. Same thing we will be referring. Then BP we had calculated, which was the second step I have told you to calculate BP. We have calculated it is TS minus RS tan delta by 2 into sin delta. Then B dash P is the third step. B dash P after BP, we have to calculate B dash P. That is also we have calculated here. Now, up till here, this first, second, and third thing we have taken from case number 2. These three things we have taken from case number 2. Now, now what we have to do? Now we can read O1S. Where is O1S? O1S, you can see O1S is here. O1S is here. O1S is equals to D dash Q. D dash Q. Where is D dash Q? D dash Q is here, D dash Q. O1S, this particular line, O1S is equal to D dash Q. O1S is equal to D dash Q. What is D dash Q equal to now? We do not know this particular D dash Q. So what we will do, we will split this D dash Q into these particular things. What are these things? PQ. PQ, okay, PQ, you can see PQ is here, plus B dash P. So what we have done, we have taken into account the whole thing from B dash to Q. We have taken the whole thing, that is from here, right? PQ plus B dash Q, the whole thing we have taken into account. Then minus what? B dash D dash, minus B dash D dash. If you do from the whole thing, if you minus B dash D dash, you will be left out with this particular D dash Q, right? We will be left out with this D dash Q. So what is the total length PQ? From here to here, it is nothing but the tangent length. It is nothing but the tangent length of the longer curve, that is TL, which you have written over here, TL. B dash P, we will keep it as it is, because we know what is B dash P already. We have seen over here, you can see B dash P is already known to us, no problem. B dash D dash is also known to us. B dash D dash is also known to us. You can see we have calculated B dash D dash. Okay, so with this, we have calculated the fourth step. Okay, O1S, I have told you O1S we have to calculate. So that is also done. O1S is also done. Now, after O1S is done, what you have to do? You have to do one step in the figure. We have to draw a particular thing in your figure. Let me show you what you have to draw. So this is your figure number 2, right? Figure number 2. Here, what you have to do? We have to extend this particular line DD dash. We have to join this particular line DD dash and extend it. Now, where is D, D dash? Where is D, D dash? You can see D, D dash is here. D, D dash. D and D dash is here. What we will do, we will join this particular D, D dash and we will extend it. Extend it, it will automatically join at T2. Okay, it will join at T2. It has to join at T2. If you have not drawn properly, it will not join. But here you can see it is joining perfectly. D1, D2, we will join and we will extend it up to T2. So I'm joining this particular d1 d2 and I'm extending it to meet it at t2. Okay, so I have drawn what? Draw d d dash and extend it to t2. Then this we can see we have formed a small triangle d dash q t2. We have formed a small triangle we have formed. Okay, I hope you are able to see. So this particular small triangle, I have drawn an enlarged view over here for you to understand. This particular small triangle d dash q t2, d dash q t2, I have drawn an enlarged view over here for you to understand. Now this particular angle is 90 degrees, 90 degrees. So this is a right angle triangle. This particular angle is 90 degrees because this is a tangent, because this is a tangent. Okay. Now this particular angle delta 2 by 2, it is nothing but delta 2 by 2. Let me write down this delta 2 by 2. So how have we arrived at this particular delta 2 by 2? It is nothing but this angle, right? Delta 2 is here. You can see delta 2 is here. So whatever angle is here, half of it will be over here. Okay, that is a property and some trigonometric functions we will use and we have arrived. Okay, it is directly, you can write down, no need for any derivation. There, whatever angle is here, delta 2, that half will be over here. That is what I've written over here, delta 2 by 2. Okay, now this is a right angle triangle. Now from here, what we will do, we will apply tan delta 2 by 2, tan delta 2 by 2. Now what is tan delta 2 by 2? Tan delta 2 by 2. Tan delta 2 by 2. Can you tell me what is tan delta 2 by 2 in this particular right angle triangle? Can you tell me? Tan is what? Opposite by base. Opposite by base. Opposite of that particular angle and the base of the triangle. Opposite is what? T2? T2? Q, correct? Can you tell me what is tan? It is T2.
Opposite by adjacent.
Opposite by adjacent, correct. Opposite is what? T2Q and base is what? D dash?
D dash Q.
Correct. Right? So this is what we have taken. Next. From here, okay, from here, you can see what is required. What is required? Delta 1 is required. Delta 2 is required. Also, TL is required, right? So here we have T2. Delta 2 we have in tan, right? So we can, if this T2Q is known to us, and D dash Q is also known to us, we can calculate delta 2. Okay, we can calculate delta 2 from this particular equation. Now, we know the particular, this particular property, right? Delta is equal to what? Delta 1 plus delta 2. Delta 1 plus delta 2. We know delta 2. We know delta, right? We can calculate delta 1. Right? So from here, we have calculated delta 1. We have calculated, sorry, we are, we have delta 1. We do not have delta. We do not have delta. We have delta 1 given to us, right? Delta 1 is given to us. Sorry, delta is given to us. This particular value is given to us. This we have calculated. Now we are left out with delta 1. So we can calculate delta 1. What is delta 1 is equals to? Delta 1 is equals to delta minus
delta. Delta minus delta 2.
Correct? I hope you are following. Okay. So we have successfully now calculated what? Delta 1, which was required. Delta 2 was required. So we have calculated delta 1. Right? You can see we have calculated delta 1. We have calculated delta 2. Now what is left? TL is left. Correct? TL is left. So for TL, what you have to do? We have to... Okay, for TL first, before we move on to TL... this is not case. This is not case 4. This is case 2, which I'm telling you. This is not case 4. This is case 2. Okay, so don't get confused. This is case 2. This is not regarding case 4. Okay, so this particular thing we have to do and we have to calculate for delta 2. Okay, delta 2, which was unknown to us. Okay, after this is done, now again we will look into what we will look into. We will look into this particular small triangle. Small triangle O1, O2S. O1, O2S. Let me draw it. Let me draw an enlarged view for you. This is O1, O2, and this particular dotted line. I will draw like this. Okay, this is 90 degrees. This is S. And this is what? This is, this angle here is delta 2. Okay, so this enlarged view of this particular diagram I have drawn over here. Okay, from this triangle now, what you have to do is you have to take sine of this angle. What angle is here? Delta 2. So I'll write delta 2. What is sine? Can you tell me now? Sine in this particular triangle, sine. I will give you a hint. It is opposite by hypotenuse.
Yes, O2 divided by O1 O2.
Correct. O1s by O1 O2. So we know O1 O2. What is O1 O2? It is nothing but RL minus RS. Correct. RL minus RS. So from this particular thing, right? So let me write down this particular again. Sine delta 2 is equals to what? O1s divided by RL minus RS. RL minus RS. So here in this particular case, case number four, RL we have to calculate. RL is not known to us. Okay, RL is required. So we know delta 2 value, we know. RS value is given to us, no problem. O1s also we have calculated. So all the values are known, only unknown value here is RL. So we can calculate RL from this particular equation. RL we have calculated, and what was required in case number four, what was required? Delta 2 was required. So we have calculated delta 2, right? Delta 2 is calculated. Previously we have calculated delta 2, no problem. RL we have calculated. Delta 1 can also be calculated, no problem. So these three things were required. We have calculated all these three things. Okay, so this is regarding case number four. Now, can we do case number five quickly and finish up with case number five? Yes. Case number five, modern day. Case number five. Please reply whether we should next class, sir.
Yes, sir.
Your friend Umayma is saying yes, sir. I think we should continue and we should finish. Inantire, madonre bedre. Let me just
take.
Okay. We'll do in next class. I'll just give you an overview what you have to do. I'll read what is this particular case. Okay. I'll just read and I will tell you an overview and we will finish. Okay. Case number five. Are you able to read case number five? Given, what is given to us? TS, TL, RL, these things are given. Okay, TS, TL, you can read. TS, TL and RL are given, no problem. Then delta 1, delta 2 and RS are required. Delta 1, delta 2 and what is required? RS is required. So what you have to do, we have to refer figure number 3. You can read on your screen, we have to refer figure number 3. That is nothing but figure of case number 3. This particular figure we have to refer again. Case number 3 figure, right? Figure number 3 I have written. This particular case figure we have to refer. Okay, figure number 3, which we have done today. Okay, so from this particular case, okay, after we refer figure number 3, we can derive this, but we can use this particular relations which we have drawn previously in case number 3. So what are these relations? B dash Q, B dash D dash, right? I tell you always first calculate B dash D dash, then calculate BP, then calculate B dash P, right? So these 1, 2, 3 things are already known to us from case 3. Okay, as in case 3, we have B dash D dash, BP and B dash P. These are known to us. And similarly, as we have done in case number four, previous case, similarly, you have to calculate O1S, okay? Then similarly, as we have joined two tangents, right, we have joined and we have extended DD dash. Similarly, in this figure, we have to extend and we have to join. And from using sine and tan, we can calculate the remaining things. Similarly, as we have done in case number four, similar steps we have to follow here and we have to solve very easy. Case number three and case number two are a bit confusing. If you understand those cases, these two cases are very easy to understand. Okay, so in the next class, what we will do, we will understand this case number five and we will understand how to particularly set a compound curve in a field. We will understand the procedure of setting out a compound curve in the field. So this is regarding your cases, which we are left out with. Only one case we are left out with, case number five. We will deal with case number five in the next class. Okay. So if you have not understood any of the parts, please let me know. I will explain once more in the next class. Okay. So this was regarding case number 3 we have studied today. Case number 2 we finished. Case number 3 we studied. Case number 4 we have studied. So I was hoping to finish case number 5, but we are running out of time. No problem. We will do it in the next class. So you can type in our attendance. And meanwhile, if anyone is having any doubts, please let me know. Please feel free to ask. Don't hesitate to ask any doubts. I know it is a bit complicated, but once you practice, you will clearly understand the things. You need to practice a bit. And if you have any doubts while practicing also, you can let me know. Everyone, please give your attendance. You can give your attendance and you are free to leave the meeting once you give your attendance.